Hey!
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Hey Paris here, and I'm back at you again with another story time. And yes, I know that I said I would do the story time yesterday, but you see, what had happened was, but that's okay because you guys are watching it today, right? Right? Okay? Okay. All right. Let's get started. I'm happy to announce that today's video is sponsored by Best Fiends. If you guys don't know what Best Fiends is, it is the most addicting app in the entire world, okay? It is a free app in the App Store. It's so much fun, so addicting, and my goal right now is to get to level 50. Right now, I'm on level 41. Best Fiend is a puzzle battle game where you can collect a ton of characters to create a team to defeat the evil slugs. It's so fun, it's so addicting, and honestly, once you get to like the higher levels, it's kind of hard. How you play the game is you connect three colors together, minimum three, but I mean, if you got more, that's even better. What? Your goal is to collect all the best fiends and discover their special powers. You get the chance to level up your fiend and help them to defeat the slug. It's a line matching puzzle game, but it's not that simple. But the further up in levels that you go to, the harder it gets, and you really get to challenge yourself while you're playing this game, and that's why I love playing it. Every time you get to a new level, it's like a new world. It's new challenges. It's just fun. Best Fiends is available on Android, iOS, and Facebook, and guess what? I can even play it on my Apple Watch. What? So download Best Fiends for free. For free. It's gonna be in the description box down below. If you're playing Best Fiends as well, leave a comment down below and let me know what level you're on. So today's story time is about the time that I got fired from my job when I was 15 years old. This is my first real job. You guys already saw the other story time where I was selling chocolates with my friend. That didn't work out too well. This is my first, like, I'm getting a paycheck type of job, okay? Let me tell you how I got fired in the first week. Yeah, the first week. So I worked at this place called No Frills. If you're from Canada, Toronto, I'm pretty sure it's only in Toronto. I'm not sure. Correct me if I'm wrong. But No Frills is a grocery store. They sell, like, cabbage and carrots and grapes and bread and cereal. Okay, that's what a grocery store is, Paris. Like, what? It's a grocery store. They sell food, okay? Me and my friend Amanda, who I have mentioned in my stories before. What up, Amanda? How you doing, girl? We were seriously on a hunt to find our first real job, okay? We applied at clothing stores. We applied at the library. What is a 15-year-old doing working at a library? You let me know, okay? We applied everywhere even though we knew that we were not eligible because we're 15, so get out of my face, dust. So, you can't really work anywhere. I mean, hello? So, we decided, you know what? We don't want to work at McDonald's. McDonald's was one of the places that we just really didn't want to work at. We decided to apply for No Frills. We applied for No Frills. We set up our resume and all that, handed it in, and literally 15 minutes later, we got a call, okay? Both of us. We were really, really excited to get the job. Like, I'm talking about ecstatic, so, so happy. Jumping up and down, doing our dances, dancing to S Club 7, doing all of that. I lied, we didn't listen to S Club 7 back then. We probably listened to Usher, yeah, you remember? Yeah, by Usher. Yeah, yeah, gonna get down, gonna come and get me. Yeah, yeah, you remember that? You guys remember that? Do you remember that song? No? Yeah, okay. So we're just celebrating, excited, knowing that we're about to make some money. Even though back then, minimum wage in Toronto was $6. Could you imagine working for $6 an hour? Crazy. Minimum wage in Toronto is now $11.50 or $11.75, something like that, I don't remember. But times have changed, bless the Lord, okay? But $6 an hour for a 15-year-old back then was like, being a doctor now, okay? $6 an hour, I was like, I am caked. I have money. Who wants me to pay their rent? Who needs their rent paid? I'm ready to pay your rent. Like, I'm a good person. How much is your rent, honey? I don't know you, but I'm about to pay your rent and make your day. Like, I thought I was rich. Working for $6 an hour. Oh my goodness. So, I wonder what the minimum wage in America is. I remember they were fighting about it recently. I hope it's not $6 an hour, because that is completely and utterly unfair, okay? That's all I gotta say, but I don't think it is. I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below. Anyways, we got the job and we went to orientation, okay? Orientation is nerve-wracking. I always hated orientation. You meet your new bosses, you meet your new colleagues. I hate it. I hated it. Oh my gosh, my eyes itching. I hated it so much. So much. Anyways, orientation comes and I meet my new boss. We're gonna call this new boss Diane, okay? We're gonna call her Diane, okay? And I actually had a real boss named Diane. So, Diane, if you're seeing this, I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about someone who I just made up right now. Not you, Diane. You're a good person. Love you, Diane. How you doing? So we're gonna call her Diane. Diane, when you first see her, you would think she's the nicest person in the world. You would think that she is jolly, just happy all the time. You're wrong. Diane was kind of like all the other bosses I've ever had in my life. Two-faced. When I first met her, she was like, oh my goodness, these pretty girls. Look at all my pretty new girls for no frills. And she gave us this folder, okay? And when I opened this folder, I was not prepared for what was about to go down, okay? Because I was 15, still in school, hated homework. But when I opened up this folder, it was sheets and sheets of paper of fruits and vegetable numbers that you have to remember in your head, so that when customers come, you type the number in and make the fruits go through, okay? You weigh the fruits, type the number in, and make it go through. This is back when they didn't have the rolly thingy where you could roll it and check the number. You had to memorize it with your head, okay? They allowed you to put it in your cashier drawer, but they said that they don't want you to take it out. That's only in emergencies. If nobody knows what the fruit is, then you take it out and you look for it, okay? Listen, I'm here to make money. I'm not here to learn about fruits and vegetables and what numbers they are. All I remember is banana was 4700. That's the only one I ever remembered, okay? Ever. Like, I never memorized anything else ever. We go through orientation. She tells us it's very important that we memorize everything on this paper and all of that. Another point I need to mention is I'm horrible at math. Absolutely horrendous at math, even up to now. If you ask me what 4 times 9 is, I'm gonna have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. Is it 36? I don't know, but I'm bad at math, okay? Let me see if it's 36, one second. Did I say 4 times 9? I don't even remember what the question was, so forget that. Anywho, what I did was I went to school and I asked my math teacher to basically help me with making change, because I was literally like, math is my worst subject of life, okay? So my teacher was teaching me how to make change, and after about 2-3 days, because we had a week before we actually started working there, I learned how to do the change. I was comfortable with it. Everything was great, okay? My teacher loved me so much, she gave me fake money to practice with at home. I love you, girl. You the truth. I love her. She was so sweet. Shout out to you. You know who you is. I don't want to say no names, because anytime I say names on my videos, you guys go and find them. I don't know how you guys are detectives like that, but I'm finished with saying people's names or businesses or anything like that, because you guys are way too detective-y, okay? Too much for me. Too much. It's my first day of work now, and we get to go on the registers. This is my first time in front of a register, in front of a screen, in front of customers. This is my first ever real job of life ever, okay? We get paired up with like people who already work there, who've been working there for years. I get paired up with an older lady, and she's teaching me everything. I'm getting everything down pat. I'm like, girl, you can go on your lunch. Like, I got this straight. Like, I'm good. Like, go ahead. I can take care of all these people or whatever. And I'm doing it. I'm doing everything right. Lady comes back. She's like, oh, good job. Like, you didn't have to call nobody. Like, everything is straight. I'm like, yes, girl, I got this. Like, I was born for no frills. What do you mean? So the next day now, we're by ourselves. We don't have anyone that we're watching over. We're not shadowing anyone. We have our own registers, our own customers. We doing everything by ourselves, okay? And I told you guys, I have a mean face. My face is always very mean, okay? And I don't mean for it to come off like that. It's just my mouth. That's all it is. My mouth, if I'm not smiling, my mouth looks like this. I look mean. I look like a mean person, okay? So I was catching out people, and what did I call her? Destiny? Not Destiny. What did I call this lady? No, that's her real name. The manager. I don't remember her name. I don't remember what I named her. But the manager came down to me and she's like, listen, sweetheart, I need you to smile. Customers come here to see your beautiful smile, sweetheart. So could you please smile more, honey, please? Because, you know, I'm running this facility and I want the people who come here to get their groceries, their eggs and their bacon, their carrots and their grapes, their cabbage and their cereal. I want them to see you smile. I want them to know that you are happy to be here with us at No Frills. You're happy to be here with us, aren't you? Are you, honey? Is this what you want to do, honey? I'm like, well, I mean, I did give you my resume. You did call me back. I did go to orientation. I am here today. So yes, I do want to be at No Frills. Like, wait, trying to make some money. She was like, okay, honey, I'm just making sure. Just make sure you smile a little more. Make sure you're a little bit more friendly. I want them to want to come to your register, okay, honey? Thank you. And she walked away. I was like, girl, bye. We started late in the payment schedule, so I got my first paycheck, which was $37. But I couldn't complain. And what did I do with that $37? I bought the same girl who tried to poison me and cut my hair. I bought her clothes with my entire paycheck. Okay, you guys remember that story time? My friend tried to poison me and cut my hair. I used my entire paycheck to buy her clothes. You guys want to call me a bad friend for not standing up for her when she got in that fight in the other story time? Listen, I'm just saying, I'm a good person. But that's beyond the point. The day after I got my first paycheck, my $37 paycheck, I was cashing out everyone, cashing out all their stuff, not even realizing that I was doing something wrong. My manager comes downstairs and she comes to my register. She's like, Paris, could you please take the next customer and then turn off your lights and meet me upstairs? I'd really like to talk to you about something very serious. I was like, is there a robbery happening? What's going on? What you mean serious? And as she said that, Amanda was behind her. Amanda was walking behind her as well. So I was like, what did we do? Like, did I sleep? Did I do something in my sleep? Like, I know I didn't do nothing wrong. Like, what's the problem? I don't get it. So after I was finished with that customer, I turned my lights off like she asked, okay? Went upstairs to her office and Amanda was sitting there and Amanda was already crying. So I was like, what did we do? What's happening? Like, I don't understand. I sit down and I'm already about to cry because I'm like, Amanda's crying, something's going on. I don't know what I did. Like, did Amanda lie on me? Did she turn her back on me, Amanda? Really, Amanda? Did you, Amanda? But no, I sit down and the manager proceeds to say,
I feel like I need to let both of you guys go because I've talked to both of you guys individually about smiling at the customers and you guys aren't smiling enough. I need you guys to be smiling at every given moment. You have to act as if this food is your family. You need to be happy at all times, girls. And I'm tired of telling you.
Tired of telling who? You told me one time. And my thing is, I'm getting paid $6 an hour. You better be paying me an extra $2 at least if you want me to be smiling 24/7. Food is not that happy. I'm not that happy to be here selling people food. I'm not. Could you imagine going to cashier and she's just checking out your stuff like, I would be like, girl, what's wrong with you? Why are you so happy? And the thing is, no one else who's been working there for years was smiling 24/7, okay? It would be different if we weren't saying hello to the customers when they came to the register. That was not the issue. The issue was we were not smiling 24 hours of the day, okay? Like, give us a break. This is our first job, our first real job with real money. Like, can you please just give us a break? Like, hello. Got fired. She fired us. Well, she didn't really fire us. Listen to this now. I am the type of person, I'm not kissing no one's butt, ever. I'm never going to be kissing no one's butt. And when we were up there, she was basically asking us to kiss her butt. She said,
I mean,
I think I have to let you guys go, but if you could name something to me or explain to me what you can do differently to stay here with us at No Frills, I might give you another chance.
You don't gotta give me no chance. I'm up out of here. Bye. I'm not gonna give you reasons why I wanna stay here. I'm 15. I can find another job. This is not a career move. This is not my career. I'm not going to sit here and beg you to allow me to work at your facility for $6 an hour selling people carrots and cabbage. I'm sorry. No. I grabbed Amanda, we held each other by the arms, and we walked up out of there. We went upstairs, we got our coats, called our moms. I said, Mommy, yes, they fired me, girl. Girl, they fired me. You better come pick me up, girl. I'm waiting outside. My mom picked us up, we explained what happened to her, and my mom was laughing. She was like, because you didn't smile? I was like, exactly, because we didn't smile. And that's the first time that I ever got fired from a job. The first and only time. No, I lied. I got fired at Limite 2. Anna, if you're watching this, I bet you didn't know, girl. I got fired from Limite 2. Limite is a clothing store that is now shut down. So who's laughing now, huh? Who's laughing now? But I guess that's a story for another day. They were petty. So petty. The people at Limite were so petty. But anyways, that's a story for another day. But I want you guys to leave in the comment section down below and let me know which story time you guys want to hear next. Do you want to hear about why I quit my job at Sephora or my Mac horror story? Leave it down below. The person with the most likes on their comments, that will be my next story time on my channel. If you have a situation like this, please let me know in the comment section down below as well. What was the first job you ever got fired from? Or have you ever been fired from a job? Or have you fired someone from a job? You little mean manager girl or man or boy or whoever you are. You mean. Don't fire nobody unless they're stealing or they're being rude. My new vlogs will be up this week. I'll leave it in the description box down below. If you guys didn't know, I do have a vlogging channel, Life with Paris Vlogs. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys. Don't gotta tell you twice. And I'll see you on the flip side. Bye, guys. What's up, guys? It's your girl, Hey Paris, here. And I'm back at you with a very, very random video. Ever since I was a little girl, I've always wanted a twin sister. I've also wanted to do this like jump thing where the scenes like jump like that. I think it looks really cool, so I decided to try it out today. And obviously, that can't happen no more. So I've decided to ask you guys for your help in looking for my doppelganger.
But what's a doppelganger?
Research says that everyone in the world has 7 doppelgangers. So doppelganger is basically someone who looks exactly like you in every single way, shape, or form.
What research said that?
Girl, I don't know.